hitter.
Lead up! All right!
Hey, hey, I hit third. Who's clean up?
This is no way to choose a batting order.
Right, oh, yeah,
it
right.
It certainly isn't. What we need is someone to make these important decisions. A manager. And I was thinking that I would
be perfect. Hey, here comes Johnny. Let's see what he thinks.
Hi, Bunch. I thought you might like to meet an old friend of mine, Sparky Anderson, manager of the Detroit Tigers.
Wow! Real manager, just what we've been looking for.
Yeah.
How do you do, Mr. Anderson?
All right.
I hope that when I become a manager someday, I can equal your remarkable winning percentage.
Thank you.
For those who may not know it, Sparky Anderson is not only the former manager of Johnny and the Cincinnati Reds, but also owns the second best winning percentage among active managers, and the third best of all time. As the skipper of Cincinnati's famed Big Red Machine, Mr. Anderson won 5 division titles, including 4 pennants and 2 consecutive world championships. Now as a manager of the young Detroit Tigers, he is working on building another championship.
Harold, you have your facts straight, all right, but don't forget Sparky's powers of persuasion. If you want to be a manager, Harold, you have to learn how to communicate.
You know, John, this young man has a way with words.
But like all successful managers, first of all, you have to have good players, and that's the secret to a good team with hard work. You have good players, hard work, and willing to practice and practice hard. Now, we're going to get ready here to practice, and I'm looking for a volunteer.
Oh, me. I'll do it. I'm a great volunteer. Come on, Mr. Anderson. You do it. I'm a good one.
You. Oh, you look like you're ready for some hard work. What position do you play? Pitcher. Oh, well, let's go to the mound and get to work.
Here we go again. That chicken has all the fun.
Oh, what's he going to do now? Oh,
check it. Enough now. Let's get serious. The ball's hit to the right side of the first base. Where are you supposed to go? You go to first base. Chicken, you're not supposed to be a base runner. You're supposed to take the throw. Now get back to here over the mound. Hurry up. Now you've got a batter that looks like he hit a triple. Where are you going to go? Now you gotta go over here and back up third. I said back up third, don't run backwards. Hey, the outfielder just bobbled the ball. Where are you gonna go now? Watch out! Chick.
What are you doing?
I know you're poop, Chicken. Why don't we take time out and see how the major leaguers back up the bases? Whenever a ball is put in play, fielders must back each other up. On the throw to first, the catcher comes down the line to do it. And if the runner takes too wide a turn at first, he can be tagged out. Even in the majors, plays often misfire. That's why backups are essential. On the throw to third, the pitcher is the backup man. Watch how it works. High throw, but the pitcher's right there. Now here's one of baseball's most important plays, the relay. The outfielder throws to the infielder, who comes out to get the throw. He then turns and fires home. Picture perfect execution. Relays need backups too. The outfielder will overthrow the shortstop, but the third baseman backs it up and throws the runner out. Perfect.
The point of all those plays, Bunch, is that when you're on the field, you're on duty all the time, and you have to know where you're supposed to be, and you have to get there in a hurry.
Now, generally, when the ball's hit to right field, the second baseman will go out, and he'll take the relay throw. But when the ball's hit to left field, the shortstop will go out and take the relay throw.
Sparky, as a catcher, I'm usually the last one to get the throw on the relay. So I know how important it is for the infielder to get as close to the outfielder as he can, then get directly in line between the outfielder and the base. Then he holds up his arm so that the outfielder can see him. And then yell, hit me, so he can hear you.
Hit me, hit me! Whoa!
Hold it. We're going to choose teams now so we can practice all these techniques. But what we're going to do is choose 2 teams of 4 players on each team. And then we're going to go throw down the line back and forth three times as fast as possible. Okay, John, let's choose teams.
All right, I got odds, sudden death.
I got even. All right, one time. One, two, three, shoot!
Wait, two out of three.
Oh, man, you pull this every time. All right, I'm a softie for you.
All right, here we go.
You ready? One, two, three, shoot!
That's one, that's odds. All right, okay.
I'm a little trouble, aren't I?
Feel a little collar, tightening up a little bit. All right, here we go.
You ready?
Sudden death.
Ready. One, two, three, shoot!
I get first choice, All right. Let's see, who do I want to take here?
Me, Johnny.
Oh, all right, Sam, you can be my catcher, all right?
Lori, that's my man. Get over here, Lori.
Kate, get over here.
Hey, Ricky, get over here with me, big guy.
Let's see, Freddie.
Well, I tell you, I have to lean to the pretty little thing with pigtails. I'm going to take Michelle, my left-hander.
Come here, Oz. Give me five. Stay alive.
Hey, let me tell you something, Harold. You ain't last for me, big guy. You're first in my heart. Come over here, partner. Give me five. Right on, man. Right on.
All right. We ready to start?
Johnny, we forgot the chicken.
So we did. Hey, chicken, why don't you be your own team and try to run back and forth and beat the relays?
Yeah.
All right, gang. Let's go. Everybody in line.
Come on. Go to your places now.
Everybody in your position.
Everybody go to your places.
All right.
That's right.
You got it? Everybody in line now. Stay in a straight line. Remember the things we talked about?
Come on, boy. You can do it, boy.
Arms up. Everybody ready? On your mark. Get set. Go.
Come on now. Let's go, Michelle.
Come on. All right. Come on, gang.
Come on, Ricky.
Now you're standing away. Look at Louie handling that ball.
Look at Ricky, baby. All right. Come on, Harold.
Come on, Michelle. Back to Harold. Freddie, come on.
Take your time.
Come on, Ozzie.
Come on. Now, come on, Ozzie.
Come on,
now
let's go, Michelle.
Look at
Ricky, baby.
All right. The baseball
bunch will return.
What you doing, Harold?
Got a niche or something?
No, Harold's just acting as my third base coach. He's the manager's right-hand man. Anybody who wants to manage should first coach third base.
I always wondered what those guys were doing out there.
He does plenty. The most obvious thing is that he directs traffic.
Like a policeman?
No, he wears a different cap and a different uniform and doesn't wear a whistle. But he does act like a traffic cop.
What do you say we look at some major league traffic cops do their thing? When functioning as the traffic cop, the third base coach must be on the alert for any possibility. He may signal a runner to apply the brakes, to hit the deck with a slide, or the signal may be to keep motoring for home. The traffic cop can direct a runner any way he chooses, except this. Sometimes third base coaches get excited. Now, if a coach grabs a runner, he's automatically out.
Well, how is the coach supposed to tell the runner that he's to stop?
Well, Michelle, that's pretty easy. There's three basic signals that you use so we don't make any mistakes. First of all, we want to stop the man. So we have what we do is this. That's the red light, stop. And then we have the caution signal, which means slide down the yellow light. Right. And now we're going to have our favorite one, the green light, that keeps going. What do? Oh, that's perfect.
Whoa, wait a minute, chicken. No, the sign Harold was giving you, you got your signals crossed. That means hold up. Oh, chicken, no. No. The sign you were giving meant for the runner to keep going home.
Anyone should know about signs without talking. It should be you, Chicken.
Yeah. Right, it's an art to give signs without talking. Yeah, hey, Hotshot, before you get too swell-headed, you know, the easiest thing about coaching third base is giving signs to the base runners. But now, when you have to get signs from me and have to give the secret signs to the players, that's going to be a little tougher. Let's see how good you are. Just follow me now.
Chicken's going to be your third base coach?
He's going to be my third base coach.
Oh, this ought to be good. All right. Let's see this.
Come on, Chicken. Come up here. We'll show him. Now, you just follow me, Chicken. Watch. There. there. You got that? Okay, now we'll do it this way. Watch me, chicken. There, 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 there. Okay, now, chicken, watch it. It's real easy. Here, 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 here. Okay, you got that? You're very good, chicken. Okay, now the easy. Now that you got them so easy now, chicken. One more.
Oh, my. Well, Bunch, are you confused now?
Yeah!
I don't blame you for being confused, because baseball's secret sign language is a tough one to decode.
Watch as Coach Roger Craig tries desperately to explain his signals to a couple of Japanese baseball experts.
Okay, now, say I give them steal. Okay. Now they foul off. Okay, now you count. Look. 3, 4, 5. Steal. In other words, if I say I start here, that's 4. All right, now, if I keep going, 5.
Steal. 1, 2, 3.
No, 1 is 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now, if I give you this, 3. Okay, Bunch.
Why?
Okay, I think I can clear up this mystery about signs for you. It really is very simple. The indicator, which is the most important thing for you to look for, indicator means that after I touch the indicator, it will be the sign after that that you're looking for. We have 4 signs: take, bunt, hit and run, and steal. And we'll use the box. So that'll be take, that'll be bunt, that'll be hit and run, and that'll be steal. The indicator will be my left arm, so I'll take my right hand, and when I put it on my left arm, it will be the first thing after that that means anything. Left arm, that would be the take. Bunt, hit and run, steal. Anything else after that means nothing. All that is just camouflage so the other team don't know what we're doing.
Okay, Bunch, you want to try one?
Yeah!
All right, bunt sign. Okay, we're giving camouflage sign. Now the bunt. Indicator down to the bunt. No, that indicator means that that's the alert sign. That means it's the first thing after the alert or the indicator. We call it indicator. So you can touch here, 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 here. Now start. Now look to see where he goes next, okay? There. All right? Remember, that was a take, the bunt, and the hit and run. So he went indicator, hit and run. All right, let's try it. Let's see your take sign. You don't want the hitter to hit swing at this pitch. That's right. Try to use it so that it goes here, so that when you're standing 90 feet away from the batter and they're looking down there, you might confuse them. Okay, Bunch, what is this sign?
Time to fry the chicken?
Lunchtime!
Yeah, I figured that, Sam. No, it's time to watch as the major leaguers do it.
Baseball Bunch will return after these messages.
Atlanta Braves.
Yeah.
Bobby Cox.
Oh, I got one. San Francisco Giants.
Frank Robinson.
New York Yankees.
Gene Michael.
Hey, Johnny, Harold knows every manager in the major league.
Yeah.
Well, why don't we look at a few that Harold may not know? Because they're well before his time. Mine, too, for that matter.
Way back in 1902, the old New York Giants hired as manager a brilliant and very stubborn fellow named John J. McGraw. When his Giants won a pennant in 1904, McGraw refused to play the World Series because he didn't like the American League president. Little Napoleon, as he was called, kept the Giants near the top for almost 30 years. McGraw's top rival in those days was Connie Mack, manager of the Philadelphia Athletics. Mr. Mack always wore a suit and expected his players to act like gentlemen. He won more games than anyone, but also lost more because he managed for, get this, 53 years. The New York Yankees had several great managers, but none so colorful as Casey Stengel, who brought them 5 straight world championships and 10 pennants in 12 years. Casey eventually left the Yankees for the young New York Mets, built a future champion while drawing fans with a style and language all his own.
As soon as the kid could talk, he started to say, Metsy, Metsy, not Papa, not Mama, Metsy, Metsy, Metsy. So that's what they are. They're now singing the kids, Metsy, 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 see where they want food and everything. So the babies are even started. We got them from 4 years on, we got them from 10 years on, 15 years on, 18 years old, and we got them in a group. They have their own groups that come out here. It'd be just like you're giving a banquet at our ball games. Each group comes out with their own group, and it's been spelled down, and of course we've drawn over 1 million people who could do that.
Johnny, when I become a manager, will I have to learn to articulate like Mr. Stengel?
No, Harold. Knowing the game and earning the respect of your players is what counts. But one thing all good managers had in common was the players let them do the talking. Uh-oh, I think I said the magic words. Oh, Dugout Wizard, what magic words bring you to us today?
You said them, Johnny. Let the manager do the talking. And just so there's no misunderstanding, let me repeat those 6 magic words. Let the manager do the talking. How many times have I seen a player argue with an umpire on a close call only to get thrown out of the game when he's most needed by his team? Talk is cheap, but players should let their bats and gloves do the talking on the playing field. Simple? Right. But oh, how often they forget. They get thrown out of the game. And why? Because they didn't let the manager do the talking. That's one of the main things a manager does. Talk, talk, talk. If it helps the team, he'll talk to anybody about anything. Now, umpires may think the manager talks too much, and probably they do. But so what? Talking is one of the things they get paid to do, and one of the things they do best.
You worry me to death. You talk too much. You even worry my pet. You just talk. Talk too much. You talk about people that you don't know. You talk about people wherever you go. You just talk. Talk too much. You talk about that you never seen. You talk about people, you can make me scream. You just talk, talk too much. You talk about people that you never seen. You talk about people, you can make me scream. You just talk, talk too much.
Just make sure you don't talk too much on the playing field, especially to umpires.
Everyone will be better off if you let the manager do the talking.
Well enough said. Let the manager do the talking. But the players shouldn't stand around like zombies. They should be able to concentrate at the right time. And they shouldn't talk back to the umpire.
Johnny, we're not in the mood for talking. We're in the mood for playing.
Yeah!
Okay, that's fair enough. But first, let's do our review.
Okay.
The backup. When the ball is put in play, the fielders must always back each other up. The relay. Get in line between the outfielder and the base you're throwing to.